I think the most common thing that students have told me since I've arrived here was, wait, we have a greenhouse? So I think, yes, it's a hidden gem that people don't know that the resource is here. We have 3 or 4 students that work in the greenhouse at any given time.
Something I would love other people to know about the greenhouse is that it's here. I talk to all of my friends. A lot of them have never heard of this place.
My vision for the greenhouse is that it can be a space where people feel welcome and where the environment is conducive to learning. The other thing that I envision happening in the greenhouse is that it becomes a space where students can brainstorm and think of projects that they're interested in and have space open for them to do those projects. Hands-on learning is so critical. We're trying to create experiences that, you know, that generate lasting memory around not only specific tasks or skills that need learned, but critical thinking, right? The ability to problem solve through issues that arise.
I want to be able to help people with this hydroponics, with these greenhouses. We have a lot of technology at our fingertips, so when we talk about food security and making sure that worldwide people have enough to eat, that's what I've been really learning, is how to make that a reality.
It's important to me to use sustainable practices because we've been asked to be stewards of the earth. And I think that part of being stewards of our environment is putting in the effort, and the other part is learning. We have a student that is doing a deep water culture project. So this is hydroponics, where you use a raft, a piece of foam, and you have plants that are growing in pouches or baskets with their roots directly in the pond. And in this case, it would be an aquaponic setup where we have tilapia providing the fertilizer in the water and the plants providing the service of cleaning the water. The unique thing about this project, I think, is the application to developing countries is that, can we use trash materials, right? Can we use recycled juice cups or yogurt containers or plastic bags to create these systems instead of the traditionally more expensive hydroponic net pots? I think that the biggest difference at BYU in our life science greenhouse from other greenhouses that I've worked in is the environment, right? And by that I mean the human environment, the interactions that happen with students and faculty, the excitement that people have for the resources that we have here. And so what I really love about being here at BYU is the focus on undergraduate education and mentored learning and involving students in research, and the ability to really use the greenhouse as a tool for experiential learning, for hands-on learning.
Some of the research that we do is geared towards improving quinoa. And so having the greenhouse is really indispensable. It lets us be able to dramatically expand the number of students and the quality of the research that we're able to do. And our students are heavily involved in our work here. This is really something that's looking out into the future. And as we think about how to make even urban environments more productive in terms of how we can feed people, we see this as a really natural and important part of the kind of research that we're doing to try and impact the world and our communities here at BYU.